Hello everybody and welcome back to another American Truck Simulator video here on the Gamer Donnie channel. Today we're going from Sonora to Santa Cruz, California. For a short haul, we're going to pick up some special car. And this is what we're going to be driving. This is the Peterbilt 379, but John Ruta. It's a C16 with Z mods in it and an 18 speed. This is the Featherlite NASCAR hauling trailer version 1.5 with the Truck and Donnie gamer skin on there. Or Gamer Donnie trucking skin, I should say. There's one thing I need to change real fast because I see it didn't save it. Because the game crashed on me before I had a chance to. But it'll only take a second here. And it will get on the road. Okay, well first we gotta put standard rims on, standard chrome. There, and put that on white. Go to the rim, go to the cover. We're just gonna use the basic. Not gonna worry about the lug nuts or anything like that. Same thing to the back. Standard chrome. Goodyear RTD tires right there. And the cover is going to be just that one. Yeah. Standard chrome. RTD. White. Back here. Cover chrome. And those covers don't look right with that chrome. The chrome's too different. Let's try premium. Yeah, premium looks better. I usually go with the spiked, but we'll go with premium. Alright, now we're ready to roll. Need to put a different front bumper on it, but I'll do that some other time. While we're here, let's go ahead and repair the truck and trailer. Then we can hit the road and get out of here.
Okay, here we go.
We'll go down here to the Wahlberg to pick up this car. Headlights on here. It's only 6 o'clock in the morning, so I don't want to get no ticket or anything like that. It'll be a pretty straightforward trip. If I do one more after this one, this one's going to be kind of a short one. I think it's only like 180 miles. So.
Turn left.
My employees are finally starting to make a little bit of money. Usually just go straight and around the building, but this one's a little different.
Final.
The way it's set up. Cargo market. And right there, the chopped LTFD Illust 300. He's still cleaning that window. He's been cleaning it for 3 years now. In the same spot. Load her up, boys.
Never mind. I'll find a new route.
Alright, 166 miles. Takes 4 hours, is what it says. To get like probably 20,000 off this or something. Yeah, 20,000. Santa Cruz to the Volson. 41,662 pounds. That's a heavy ass car. I think it weighs more than a truck and trailer. Almost twice as much. Alright, let's get on the road. We ain't not making no money sitting there. I figure we buy two more trucks, hire two more drivers, and we start saving money up for a Pinga truck. Special DLC hauling, oversized hauling loads coming out. Look like wind turbines from the picture. Big blades and the towers. Gonna be a DLC. I'd say if it's free or paid, I imagine it's probably gonna be paid. Thank you. to be a pretty straightforward trip. I don't expect anything to go wrong, but like I say, expect the unexpected. I like the fact that I like the fact that they're adding new content and things into the game and updating it. It makes me want to keep playing it more. If they wouldn't ever update it or add things to it, I probably wouldn't be playing it too true. They got a little bit of more competition out there. Other people making truck driving games, they're gonna start pushing it a little more. To make it bigger and better. A full tank of fuel. Should have enough to make there. It's only 130 miles. After this load, we'll buy us a new truck and hire us a new driver. And we'll do one more load, and that'll probably be the end of this episode.
Go straight on. Keep right, and then turn right. Turn right.
Straight on. 8:30 and turn lights off. What's this shit? Wrong button and hit the fucking jailbreak button. In real life, you would never be able to get it in gear like that. It just wouldn't go. You can push on it with your fucking foot and it wouldn't go in gear. we are off. I damaged my truck, didn't it? No, it doesn't show it. It's wrong button. Can't push escape to back out. Oakland. Oakland, Kansas. I thought Ironworks Kenworth W900. I just haven't added it into this game profile yet. Pretty nice truck. Oakland Bridge. I don't remember what the name of the bridge is. It's called Oakland Bridge. I keep hitting my damn elbow. A small town. That big container ship you seen in the spotlight pictures, photos. How did it break off? Oh shit, I want to hit that bridge. That'd give you a headache for sure. Gotta be over here. Well, I did put some new stacks on here, some 10-inch stacks with a 90-degree turnout. Any dip in an ocean, shark biting on your wiener. My luck would be electric eel or something. I don't think they have electric eels in the ocean.
Looks like only freshwater.
Jellyfish sting on the wiener would hurt. Well, that did turn the spawn rate down on these trailers, so you shouldn't really see a whole bunch of them. It's kind of like real life. You're not going to see 50 trailers every 5 miles. Yeah, about that turn. It'll be a negative on that one, driver. I don't know if there's a fucking ditch like that right there. Gotta swing it wide. Something comes with a cool design for my, I like my Gamer Derby trucking logo. I just want, it needs something added to it. I could change like the trucking part of the lettering. But I want to keep the GD and the font and the way it's set up. I want to keep that the same like it is. Did it add like something to a background or something? With some wings on it? I don't know. Alright, let's see if we get this nasty pig in there. I still don't know if we're gonna make it. Yeah, I think we will. Maybe. Yeah, we got it made. Was that overhang done hit that fence right there? And it did. And it did. Doesn't look like it. It looks like there's a good foot and a half there, but collision box says otherwise. I'll do it from outside. I don't think it's gonna go in there, not this angle. There's a collision box. Barely. Nope. That's kind of dumb right there. I mean, it's fucking... reason in there. Had plenty of room. Plenty of room. Looked like it to me. I did something like the bolts and trailer over there, but instead of gears and shit, the GDs, that might be alright, something like that. I don't know, I'll figure something out. 160 miles, 5 hours, 48 minutes, 30 gallons of fuel, $21,210 I earned. Level 19. Alright, let's check out our company job offers. I like good, a whole good Duschenberger. I don't see any though. I like this car. I like saying it. It's just one word to say, I guess. I ain't been up the coast in a while. I'm gonna head up the coast up here to Yucra. The 1968 Camaro Z28. Oh shit. I don't know if I get this thing turned around in here. Yeah, we'll give it a try. We'll see what happens. Okay, let's check dealers. See if I can do it this way. My Freightliner stock. My fleet configuration. Find out from this brand. What? Right, we'll do it this way then. Purchase. Bam. You know, 40,000 left. Uh oh. I don't think that's enough to upgrade it. Copy config. Bam. Bam. 4,000? Oh, okay. Yeah. I'm more than plenty to upgrade it then. Bam. Okay, driver recruiting agency. Hire a driver. AAA, she's only 1.7. What's the pay? 1682 miles. $10 more delivery. Why is... hazmat, this is just in time delivery, and special loads, fragile, and economy, eco, Coleco. Fragile on time. Alright, we'll go with Reese. Congratulations, Reese. Welcome aboard. Gamer Donnie Chuckins. Those are 34,000 left over. I did pay the bank off. Pretty sure I did. Unless it didn't save it. Yep. Bank is paid. You can borrow $5,788 a day. I mean, that could be done. It's a lot of money, though. That will fill up one. We'll fill up our last spot in our garage, and then we'll work on getting the Pinga truck. Well, actually, we want to work on getting another garage, so we'll have another spot to buy the Pinga truck. I could just trade this one. We'll figure it out one time. I'm not saying anything about too much. Confuse myself. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to swing all the way to the left as far as possible. We're going to try to back it up a 90 degree angle back into the left hand driver side and then pull on out. So basically, we're going to back this feather kind of beside that bolt and try to do there, more or less. Always want to get as close as to the parking spot or wherever you're trying to put that trailer. I'm not gonna make that. I don't think. Barely. Somebody ran into it before. It's already been like that. That wasn't me. Okay. The fucking collision box again. I think it's gonna be the death of me, man. Some of those days. Alright, turn it off at an angle. Loom's right up in there. That's what we're gonna get. Let's flip it out. Back to the left. Right. We're gonna just back it straight around. Keep it up, I'm gonna put one of these axles in a raised axle, liftable axle. Hitting that fucking space bar thinking that's change it forward backwards. Not playing Farm Simulator, Donnie. Although I didn't need to go harvest my crops. I'm not even gonna try to get out on that side over there on the right side. We're just gonna go straight through. You don't like it? Kiss my ass. Damn, it's a hell of a curve to be running over. That's dangerous. Somebody fall on that and hurt themselves. You know what the fuck did I hit this time? Going to let them back up. There it goes. From hell. Now what the fuck? What did I hit? What? Where? Curve. Cut it in so we got hit nothing. Having collision boxes are gonna be death, and this is gonna piss me off even more. And it probably damaged the truck too, didn't it? No, but it did damage the trailer. So I said 9, it was only 0. I'm gonna be such a pain in the ass. Let's get the hell out of here. Took us 30 minutes to get out of the damn parking spot. I ain't going back to that damn place again. They shoved up their ass. I thought it would be daytime so we can see the coast, but our ETA is for 7 p.m. So it's going to be dark when we get there. Unless we do some bookings. The two-lane back roads gives more of a challenge driving it. More pretty scenery too, you know, seeing all the big cities on the interstate. Unless you're in California, then you see little plots of land with 90 billion cows packed into it, shitting on each other. Since I've been down through here. $35 my ass. Better slow down and get a ticket. For a left turn. I could have went. Could have kept going, but I didn't. Ain't worth it. It's like a $1,300 ticket. Fuel situation, 154 miles, no, we still got quite a bit of fuel actually. I need to start putting my points into the fuel economy. Thank you. We would take a supervisor every fucking stoplight in town. Get GPS. Turtle it with the tom-tom. I just need a little blue car. I'm gonna have to move over because I'm coming through. That's illegal, by the way, to switch lanes in a intersection. What the fuck did I hit this time? Oh, bullshit. I can't go forward or backward. There's a reason that low gear was there. I didn't think the tree branches had a collision, but apparently they do. Take her out there for Ripberry, bud.
Go straight on. Keep left, and then turn left. Turn left.
Time for a new chair. This one keeps going down slowly. It's got like a leak in the hydraulic thing or something. You raise it all the way up, and 30 minutes later, your ass is sitting on the ground.
Go straight on.
Come on, people, we're burning fuel. Clear on left?
Clear on left.
Get ready to turn left.
We're ready to turn right. Go straight, stop, go backwards, do a donut.
Turn left, and then keep left.
Turn left, keep left. Let me go.
Thank you, good driver.
Learning.
The name of town, where do you live? Learning. What are you learning? Learning. I believe this is the 101 we're on. Poop, not third. I'm blowing the bottom transmission out. Uh-oh, here's that bridge. San Francisco Bay. Bridge. I've been across it a few times. Not too many, but a few. Much to see. I think I could have stayed in another lane, but better be safe than sorry. Look like we'll get a beautiful sunset, not this time. And we're just hauling ass through here, somebody could at least said something to. There's a weigh station through here somewhere. EPR. About an hour and we'll be there. 37 miles.
straight on.
Copy it loud and clear there. Driver. Keep right.
Exit right.
Exit right.
Get ready to turn right. Turn right.
I should say 3.8 miles per gallon? 9. Not very good, really. About 4, that's low. We'll get about 7 would be really good. Easier to get in and out of.
You have arrived at your destination.
I'll drop it. I'll unload it in the middle of the road. Put it in the middle of the road. There she is. Miles, 6 hours, 38 minutes, 35.2 gallons of fuel, got $24,916 earned. We got 1/3 of the way there, huh, to the next level. I hope you guys enjoyed.
Don't forget to like. Subscribe, share, and leave a comment down below. We'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.